knock the what? You can't knock the what? You can't knock the what? You can't knock the what? We the ones you despise. See it all in your eyes.
Can't knock the pod, episode 124. Today is a little different. Minus a few of my fellow colleagues, but I brought three of the friends along with me today. So to introduce the room today, to the right of me, I have coming back. This is your first time doing back-to-back episodes, right?
Yes.
You did so good last time that I was like,
oh, thanks. You always messing my intro, gosh, with the sidebar. Start over.
To the right of me, I have Judy.
Oh, wow.
That's what the streets call you, right?
No.
The streets don't call you Judy?
Mm-mm.
What they call you?
Auntie.
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 Auntie Judy to the right of me. We have Shaq Renee. I got to make sure I say the Renee in that because just saying Shaq doesn't do it to justice. Like, it's like O'Neal. Okay. Yeah. So the Shaq Renee, that is kind of cute.
I'm cool with that. Oh, thanks.
I kind of like that. To the right of Shaq, we have my main man returning. He has been a guest before, not on the camera, but you've been in a new studio, but you ain't been since we painted, though, right?
No, this is my first time.
Oh, this is your first time saying everything. Nice. Okay.
I like that.
So to the right of Shaq, I have my man Anthony Walker joining us today. Let me give both of y'all a round of applause.
Thank you. Oh, you're too kind.
I appreciate y'all. Now, you should be happy because I said, you know, Anthony Walker, but I won't refer to you as that no longer in the show.
Thank you. I appreciate you. Can you just call me Kush?
Okay. Yeah, I'm going to call you Kush.
Cool. Thank you, bro.
But you said don't call you Kush no more. Oh, okay. So I get it. Because Kush is a businessman. You know what I mean? How's the barbershop going?
Oh, you know what? It's beautiful, man. I only got like one booth left.
See?
Oh,
wow.
It's full, man.
That's good. That's
jumping.
Good.
All you see is women coming in busted and leaving cold.
Because y'all cut, you cut a lot of women's head.
Forget me. I got all stylists and nail tech.
Oh, you got the whole shebang there.
Yeah. I got braiders.
Mm.
That's stylists. Dope.
You know, fellas, if you've never been to a barbershop where that women come in and out, it is a...
It's a different
it's
story.
It's a difference. It's a difference. As a single man, I can say... I really appreciate that. Now, if I was married or something, I'd be like, no, listen, I'm here to get away from women, maybe. You know what I mean? Like, because
right.
I'm married type of thing. I don't know. I'm not married, so
you're
I can't
right.
say. But, we do have a married man here that is on the mic. On the camera is replacing, you know, normally Mars here. But I got my man, Joe. And if you're seeing these signs down here and you're seeing my 50th anniversary sign, courtesy of Fire Made Design, and that's Joe. So he's here. How you doing, Joe?
All right, man.
You doing good? This is Joe's first time on here, so I'm anxious to see how this, you know.
Joe, is my nameplate on like back order or something?
You want one? You
got to
check with the man.
Joe.
Check with the man.
No, she can't get one.
Joe.
So yeah, like I was saying, I think I appreciate it being women there. You know,
yeah, because you know how you have a shop conversation. It's always one-sided until it start being women at work.
But sometimes a little part of me want that one-sided.
No.
Ooh, we got to keep it one-sided on our side until, you know, one of them come over there like, wait a minute.
So y'all just be having open conversations? Like,
hell yeah.
Women? Ooh, that's lit.
Everybody open their door and now we talking shit.
Your shop around the corner of my house. I might just come post up sometime.
Come on.
But.
You got too many kids for that.
Wow.
that's really like the barbershop movie. So you really got the movie is what you have, Barbershop 3. Because that was like
one side is barbering, the other side is stylist. Everybody got their own booth.
And then you got
just random stuff in there.
And nails too, you said.
Yep. Nails. You can get a sew-in, braids, dreads.
That's dope.
Mm.
They do a little bit of everything.
That's like the Walmart of hair.
Stylist, right? Eyebrows wax.
Oh, yeah, that's definitely like, no, I'm going to say Target. I ain't going to say Walmart.
Just a one-stop shopping
strategy.
Yeah. All right.
That's cool. So today we're going to keep it how we normally keep it, go through the topics. We're going to I'm gonna start doing like a rundown of the show since we're on YouTube now. I feel like that's important. And if you haven't checked this out, the last two full episodes are on there on YouTube, as well as we're uploading clips. So this is going to be the new schedule for the podcast. And every Tuesday we will record. Audio will be released on Wednesday. So the audio that we record Tuesday will be on Wednesday. The video will be, for that particular episode, will be up on Friday with a with a rain date for Saturday.
Oh, just in case.
Just in case. So I'm, the plan is to have it.
His haircut, he really don't want to be.
The plan is to have it up by Friday. If not, it'll definitely be up Saturday. And that's going to be the plan keeping forward with Can't Knock the Pod. So I am happy for that, taking the next step. But this episode 124 with Shaq, Renee, and Aunt Kush, we're going to talk about Chris Brown, the $1,000 pitcher. Kid Cudi at Rolling Loud. I'm going to try to make a call about Rolling Loud. I didn't even tell anybody that. I know a couple of people that went, so I'm going to hit them up and see if we can get a play-by-play of what happened. Issa Rae, new show. I mentioned that. We all watched the new show, Rap Shit, and the church robbery. But we're going to start off with the new music. As we always do, new music came out. We had, I don't know, any of you guys been able to check out any of the new music that came out?
Okay. Yeah. So, yeah, let me pull my notes out.
If it was.
Well, of course, you know, first thing, Mozzy. It was cold.
Mozzy? You like the Mozzy? I listened to it, but I didn't really get to dive into it, though.
It's a typical Mozzy album. If you listen to Mozzy and you listen to the last couple, and then you listen to the earlier ones, it got those June beats with just new people on them. And it's the same content that you're looking for. It's great.
Okay. So he kept it the same how he was prior to being with CMG.
And then it's like two songs that just got them real sweet EST-type beats.
Okay.
He just killed them.
Okay. It's cold. Well, that's good to hear. So I am going to dive into that. I've been stuck on the Joey Badass album. And why did you laugh?
I listened all morning.
Why'd you laugh?
I'm not judging you or anything.
You don't like Joey Badass?
I mean,
he may not be for the average listener.
He's not.
He got the hip hop.
He is real hip hop, but I appreciate the Joey Badass because I can tell that he's not making music to support his life.
What does that mean?
Making the music I like.
He's making the music that he's like. He's making the music that he's most comfortable with. I can tell that he's just in a comfortable bag. Because if you're not hip to who Joey Badass is, he's also an actor. And he's been acting more than he's been rapping. And if you watch the Kanan show, he was in Kanan. You watch Kanan?
Yeah, who was he in Kanan?
He's unique.
He's unique.
Oh.
He's like the best character in Kanan.
Okay. He is.
He's best character. Unique was my favorite character in Kanan.
I didn't know that.
Prior to him
and Lou.
Yeah. Prior to that, he was on the Wu-Tang show on Hulu.
That was sweet.
He was on that. He didn't do that because he did the Kanan show. And he also did a short film that actually won an Oscar. So he's really in his acting bag. So he's not doing music to support his everyday. So it's not forced. You can tell he took his time with it. He sat back, picked the beats he wanted. Even one of the songs, he said he'd think of a concept, but he just really took his time making it because he's not in that, you know, that rat race to.
I liked it. The people he picked, the production.
Right.
And it's not like I'm just trying to this was in style, I'm about to do this. Even though, you know, he got that hip-hop swing, he really could be getting on them Favio-type beats and stuff like that, but he didn't. He just kept it like he liked it.
And that's what I was more, I don't need
that. I already got an album of that. So I don't need you to do the same thing. I liked it.
Yeah.
I don't know about Nardo.
Nardo, listen, I'm not the biggest Nardo fan. Nardo Wick, he released Who Is Nardo Wick 2. which is really just a deluxe to the first album. I let that mug ride, and I was hype as fuck. I was like, oh, shit. I didn't even listen to the first one.
I can't be ecstatic like that over the same sound and beats. I can't do it.
I was like, oh, this is all right. This is all right. Icewear Vezzo.
Cold.
Rich Off Pints 3. I didn't listen to the Shorty Shorty. And you didn't even check Danny Lay out?
A little bit.
I don't know who she is, so I didn't even try it. That's the chick that was the baby girlfriend?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't even know she was a person. I just thought she was cute.
You didn't know she had a career.
I just thought she was just fine and just go with little baby.
Okay.
The baby.
Yeah, the baby. Get it right.
My bad.
Get it right.
The baby.
Not the little baby.
The one with the teeth. Not the one with the teeth.
I didn't dive into the Danny Lay, which I will, because her last couple projects have been all right. Not to skip over the Icewear Vezzo, but yeah, that it's typical Icewear Vezzo.
It's a good follow up for two.
Yeah, it's typical. I want to see him kind
of
take
five of 14 songs already. Though,
yeah, so. I want him to take another step though. You know what I mean? Like expand more than what he's doing, because he's good. I like him.
I need him to go back to that Clarity 6 where he had to basically make the whole album by himself.
He a real fan. You a fan.
Okay. That's probably my favorite rapper besides Kanye, for real.
Besides Kanye? Mm-hmm. Oh, wow.
Seriously.
Okay. Yeah, that's all I really got from music. I mean, that was like a quick run through.
What about that DVSN?
Oh, we're going to get into that. That's a whole topic in itself. That's a whole topic in itself. It's terrible. I do want to say I did like the feature with on the Joey Badass with West Side Gun. And my man Joe really don't like West Side Gun. But that was a real good.
That's the number one song I listened to today. I listened to it probably four times.
It just sound rich, don't it?
Yeah.
Wait, they don't like each other?
Brand new 911.
Who?
You saying Joey Badass?
No.
Oh, Joe.
Joe, say it ain't so.
This guy right here.
That guy right there he's not the biggest fan of, you know, Joey Badass. I mean, of West Side Gun. But Diddy's on the intro of the Joey Badass. That's what stood out to me as well. He basically told him, like, if you want to make classic music, use instruments. And you could tell he used all instruments for the beats. It sounded real rich, real, like,
Classic.
Like, that's why I say you can just put that mug on and do whatever you do. Off of new music, just moving on. So you want to go into Division, because you mentioned that. That's where you want to. Did you guys hear this song?
Yeah.
I need you in the mic a little bit.
The only reason I want to talk about it is because the comparison was supposed to be to what? Marvin's Room?
Yeah. So
Confessions?
Division, if you don't know who it is, DVSN. Yes, it's a group. It's two people. A lot of people still get confused on that. It's a group. They dropped a new song called If I Get Caught, which samples Jay-Z's Song Cry, which pissed me the hell off.
It was the worst sample Song Cry I've ever heard in my life.
Sample Song Cry like that. Like,
was it that bad, or was y'all like overly hyped about it?
No, I didn't.
I heard it. I don't think it was that bad. I was expecting more because it was so hyped up. Everybody was saying it was so toxic.
See, I heard it the other way. I didn't hear nothing about it and just listen to the song.
Oh, okay.
Me too.
So I didn't see the hype behind it. I just happened to listen to it and I was like, oh, okay, let me see what this is. So I don't even think my phone's hooked up. Hold on. I'm going to play.
It was a bad sample of Song Cry. Like, why would you do Song Cry like that?
Well, it was produced by Jermaine Dupri.
Oh, yeah, of course.
And Jermaine Dupri had came out and said that, you know, it was going to be a great song. You know, they changing the game. Before it dropped, they compared the song to, they claimed it was going to be up there with Song Cry, The Weeknd by SZA, Song Cry by Jay-Z, The Weeknd by SZA, Confessions 2 by Usher, and Marvin's Room by Drake. Like, he was going to fall into that realm of songs. And,
It didn't quite give
what it was supposed to give. It didn't quite do it. The video wasn't even fire. Like,
but was it a bad song?
Yes.
I know. I don't know. We're not going to play the whole song, but
y'all are a tough crowd.
Man, they compare it to these greats.
Just fucking them girls. I was going to get right back. Just fucking them girls. I was going to get right back.
You wouldn't want me if you thought I never had hopes.
That's true. That's true. Gotta
women
have hoes.
Like men, other women like. That's just something that everyone knows. Don't forget I was a fly nigga when you got here. Yeah. Charismatic when you got
y'all
here.
Bugging.
You knew about me when you got here.
Not gonna lie.
Now you're y'all girl, it's not fair.
Yeah, y'all
got
bugging.
My phone in your hands. Questions. Not again. Why do we do this? When really? Truth is,
if I get caught cheating, that don't mean I don't love you.
Just fucking them girls, I was gone.
Say it again.
If I get caught cheating, that don't mean I don't love you.
Just fucking them girls, that was gone.
Listen.
Let's run it back. Let's try again. Listen,
this is what I will say.
I hate the sample. I just hate the sample.
But
the lyrics fire.
Hook, the lyrics is fire.
Hook trash. Lyrics fire.
I feel if you're gonna sample it.
They sampled song Crawl Room.
You didn't need you just didn't need it. It's a good song. I'm not gonna say it's not a good song. It's a good song. The lyrics are I wanna get a tatted on me right now. Like I wanna go get these lyrics tatted on me right now.
You got tattoos.
I got two tattoos. That's it.
That was a waste of money.
You said what?
That was a waste of money.
My tattoos?
No. The sample. Like paying for that sample and just having Jay.
No,
right.
Y'all were just expecting something else and it wasn't that. I like that he just.
But I didn't have any expectations.
I did. Because I mean, but
if somebody say that they are sampling Song Cry, I feel like you just make up an idea in your head. And because that wasn't, it was so different.
Yeah.
I think that song is nice.
I mean,
no, it ain't up there with the songs he named.
It's not.
Okay.
It's not.
Let's bring it back
but,
down.
But it's the level
call
below
it.
It.
Decent song.
I like the song. Because, I mean, they say song. Some good, they say some really, really Bible stuff in here. You wouldn't want me if you thought I never had hoes.
That's
on
how,
me.
That's how on I understand me. How your slimy ass don't like it.
On
I
me.
Do like it. Why?
Like he's speaking your language.
Oh, Shaq.
Sweet Lord.
What you doing, Shaq? What you doing, man?
I'm just saying.
Woo.
I'm just saying.
This motherfucker, right? No, he say, you wouldn't want me if you thought I never had hoes. Women like men, other women like. Right? I feel bad that you got to sit up here and.
I feel like that was, like, I grew out of that.
Okay.
Now I want the dude that nobody even checking for.
Can I ask how old you are on here?
Like a hidden gem. No, you cannot. You never ask a lady.
Okay,
to age.
That's why I asked. Can I
I'm
ask?
I'm kidding. Yeah, you can.
How old are you?
31.
That's really young. So for you to be on that now, okay, I give it to you.
Yeah, I ain't. I was there. I've been there.
Mm-hmm.
But
so now you want the guy that nobody would even. Looks at.
Right. There's, it's like a hidden gem, though. Not like.
But you still want him to be attractive
yeah.
and have swag and
yes,
all that.
And that's very
But
possible.
Guess what?
No.
All that comes with hoes.
No. There are some men with some dignity, you know.
No, he can have. He just because the
he
hoes
don't
come.
He don't have to be a hoe.
Yeah, he don't got to be a hoe. But I'm just letting you know, like, women are going to want him. They're going to want that guy.
In my experience, they wanted that guy once they saw him with somebody.
Well, that's how
I do got a motto, like, and I ain't trying to be cocky or nothing like that, but like, if you want your nigga to act right, let him see that we texting. Like, I stand on that.
Oh my God.
Because every time I've been caught in a little situation, they end up with a ring.
And you don't like that song?
No, I love this. Oh, okay. I like the lyrics. I really like the lyrics of the song. I
You should.
I'm not done reading them.
Lyrics fire.
We're going to break it down.
Don't like the hook. Don't like the sample.
You wouldn't want me if you thought I never had hoes. Oh, I said that already.
You really like that line, don't you?
Right. Because like
he getting that tatted on his neck tomorrow.
Women like other women. Women like men other women like. That's just something that everyone knows. See, they're not saying nothing new. They're just saying it. Don't forget I was a fly nigga when you got here. How you think you got here?
Oh, my God.
How you think you got here?
God.
I laid the trap.
I can't.
Man, I just want to hear a cappella with no words.
You knew about me when you got here. You did your fucking Googles.
Hey, man.
You knew.
Get me a Patron. She overlooked the Carfax.
That ain't my fault. That's not my fault that y'all don't listen.
Wait a minute, mm-hmm. No. I would hope that people, you know, kind of tell people a little bit about themselves before they just dive into something.
Yeah, all the, right. All the glitz and
but
glamour.
But they don't pay attention to that. They don't care.
Yeah, I used to be a hoe, right? Yeah, I ain't tripping.
Like,
oh man,
one little fuck up take all this away. Just because I cheated don't mean I don't love you.
Okay, that's Jody.
Gas.
Message.
That's why it's been in so many different things. Right. We've been trying to say this since when did Baby Boy come out? We've been saying this before Baby Boy, but this is what y'all know. You know what I'm saying? This is how y'all know things because all y'all like Baby Boy.
No, but that's. We don't want a baby
2001.
Boy.
2001. Y'all wasn't even outside.
We don't want a baby boy, though.
But I'm just saying, just because I cheated don't mean I don't love you. I love the fuck out you.
That's just like
it hurt me more than it hurt you.
The green light to at least cheat once.
How I know you really love me if I don't cheat once?
Oh, my God. This is so bad. I like that song. You make me not like it.
She about to hate the song.
Like, my nigga is not allowed to listen to this.
I'm just reading lyrics. I'm just playing, y'all.
We good. We got the point. It's slimy. Okay.
Hey, listen, hey. Hey, look, I can't help you on this line right here, y'all. This.
Would you rather be the girl to cry in a Corolla or a fart?
You gonna be crying in the GMC? I ain't got the form for you.
God.
Like, and y'all be crying in worse cars.
I hate that line.
Y'all be crying in. Y'all be crying.
If I had to choose,
right? Y'all be crying in fucking rentals.
Rentals,
rental cars.
Altimas.
Oh my goodness.
04s. Fuck is you talking about? 02 Malibus.
Oh man,
that's cool and all, but it's niggas like, who's not putting their girl in the foreign who gonna take this song way too far.
They is.
Yes. Yes.
Of course the world is.
I ain't perfect. Baby girl, I'm worth it. Don't forget I was a fly nigga when you got
I ain't perfect.
Okay, can we move along?
No, this is what you wanted. This is what you wanted to do.
Can we move along?
And this is what we here for. Jermaine Dupri was wilding though,
putting it up there with all of that.
Yeah, he was wilding.
He put it up there with too much gas. Like he just came in the room. Like, all right, y'all got that cookie, but I got this. It's all right, right here.
They really said this. Like, they really put up a post that said top five most honest anthems, and they included that if I get caught. You ever been caught cheating? I'm asking both of y'all. Oh,
shit. See, I looked when you looked.
Yes. I'm gonna just.
Yes. Motherfucker. It's always one.
Chat, you ever got caught cheating?
No.
Never.
I don't cheat.
You know I know you personally?
My sisters, though. You know I got sisters. And they haters. My sisters are haters.
They told on you?
Oh, they opened the door for her. They opened the door for her.
So you had another girl in there, and they was like, here, come in.
And I could hear the banging on the door. I'm like, you know, they're not going to open the door. They don't like her though. So of course, shit, Maya, let her in. Open the
Wait,
door.
They don't like her, but they let her in.
Yeah, so she can see it.
They know who was here last night.
Yeah,
I'm coming out the room. She coming up the steps. What was I supposed to do?
Man.
That's how you got that mark on your cheek?
Oh, no.
I'm just waiting. Hey,
do this with that.
Did she kick your ass?
Do this with this to bring this up.
Bring it up?
Yeah. In the middle. I'm sorry we had to do this on here. Yeah, there you go.
Like that?
Yep.
Like just that?
Tighten it up. Yep. I've never been caught cheating. Yes, I have.
When you say caught, do you mean like in the act? Or
yeah, like
somebody found
so you
out?
Was. I never actually been caught in the act. Like you was caught in the act.
Fuck no, hell no.
But she just left or something.
She was still in my room. I'm still on bone, but I caught you before you came in.
Oh, but you got caught.
Yeah, you already in the house.
But she ain't like walk in the bedroom on y'all.
Wouldn't let her.
But you got caught because she. Was
she
there.
Knew she was in the
oh,
room.
Oh, you got
though.
Caught.
She was in
the. Oh, you got caught in the act. That's in yeah. the act. That's in the act. That's.
Wait, no. Nah, you said in the act.
No, that's no, in the act.
In the she's act only there. Really happened in movies and pornos.
The act begins when she gets there and ends yeah. when she leaves.
I ain't saying like get caught deep diving. Like if you let it get that far.
You know, I know people that.
Yeah, you got caught in the act though.
I mean,
it wasn't like act three, but it was act one.
Yeah, it was like act one, act two.
Yeah, you
like
got caught two. In the act though.
Yeah, you got caught, bro. Yeah,
10 Dang steps it. Away from the door.
Shaq, you ever been
caught in the act? No. Never. Well, I got caught by the police in the act. Does that count?
In the car?
Did they find out? Did the person you were with find out?
No.
So if they listening, they're going to find out here.
This is like...
Yeah, I know this is your OG.
I think I was in high school.
Oh, you been wildin'.
Whoa.
I was in high school for sure.
She belongs to the streets.
Oh my God.
Doing your thing in high school.
I belonged to the street.
You belonged.
Thank you.
Okay.
But yes, it is.
I used to you.
Yeah, no, that was high school. Like, come
I only got caught by like cell phone type shit.
Right, yeah.
Like somebody going through my phone and shit.
That's the only other way.
Yeah, like other than that.
Y'all niggas always getting caught that way.
That's because y'all be fucking spying.
We are, and y'all know that we are like. Grade A level spies, and y'all still don't cross y'all teeth like, without y'all eyes.
Let me tell you what a woman to do to get in your phone. Right? They
the most,
will
nah.
watch and remember to see. So they look at you, you know, but not look at you, and they just see you hit like the first number. So they'd be like, eight. All right, I know the first number, eight. I catch him again in a couple of days to get that second number.
A couple, yeah.
Or whatever, or later on. Maybe you know what
hours.
I'm saying?
Maybe a couple hours.
So they don't like get caught looking at the whole number at once to alert you so you change it. So then, you know what I'm saying? They look and they see you do the O. Then they see you do the four. And like, oh, okay. 8-4. Oh.
That's rookie level stuff though.
Well, I just always had the same one. I ain't never changing my shit.
Oof. Oof. God bless.
The old me. Yeah, I used to have to change my family. Joe, you ever been caught cheating?
Nope.
You're not a... That's good, Joe.
You're a saint, Joe.
That's good, man.
I'm no saint.
Oh, that nigga's 007.
that oh, no. Double. Oh, no, Joe.
Let me see. Is that all we got for this division song? So I am here for the song. It did sound real good. It did sound good. The hook could be a little better, but...
I got two disagreements. I don't like the hook.
But I think the hook going to grow on me super hard, and I think it's going to be like...
The lyric's so cold, though.
I think the hook going to be like a chant, almost, like...
you're getting the tattoo.
Yeah, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, hold on.
I can't wait to see you driving Keisha while you just got your fist out.
Swear to goodness.
Swear to goodness.
Bumping this song. Because you slimy like that. But moving along.
I get caught cheating. That don't mean like, I don't love
you. I see all the homies like, you know what I'm saying?
No, I don't want cheating, no parts in this.
That don't mean I don't love you.
Oh my like, God. This is terrible.
I know you ain't gonna let one little fuck from the mess.
I feel like we all come together.
Never gonna see all the homies with their hands on their shoulders rocking like, back and forth like that.
Y'all gonna be collectively homeless too. Like everybody stay in that art house.
What'd you say, Joe?
Like when Bowdy used to come on.
Yeah, like we all.
This is my crib, and I'm going to be taking a bag of her art. You can get out your own shit.
So yeah. Will.
Art, man.
Oh, shit. And that's funny as fuck. Moving on, keeping the new music or music. It's Beyonce week. You know what I'm saying? We doing a deal. Y'all here for Beyonce week? Are you here for the new Beyonce album?
I hope so, but I want another Dangerously in Love. So
I was just about to say that's where our relationship ended.
Yep.
I ain't been a Beyonce fan since Dangerously in Love.
So y'all ain't like, I liked it, some songs off of Homecoming. Ooh.
Well, yeah.
I can't tell you nothing.
That shit was hard.
I can't tell you nothing that ain't Dangerously in Love or she was on a song with Jay-Z.
Did you watch The Homecoming on Netflix?
No.
You need to watch that.
Watch that with your daughter tonight.
I kid you not. I watch that with your daughter in the next week or just coming up when you got her. All
right.
Like, watch her, please. Please watch it with her.
All right.
I made my family watch it. Like, I've probably seen it 4 or 5 times.
Wow.
I'm not going to hold you. Like, it's so motivating. It's good. And just seeing her create that whole, like, it's for the show. You know what I mean? But have your daughter watch that.
All right, bet.
And then y'all bond on that. You know what I'm saying? Because you're going to fuck with it, too. You're going to be like, damn. Like, because you're a music cat. You know what I'm saying? You know you're my favorite rapper. You know.
My dog. I appreciate that.
You watch it, Joe?
Nah.
No, you should watch it, too.
Let me check it out.
It should still be on Netflix. But that's here and there about this, though. The album, they said it features Jay-Z, Dream, Pharrell, Ye, some other producers. So it looked like it's heading hip-hop-ish, hip-hop, even though that first thing was dance. But I can't even say that because Dream, Pharrell, and Ye,
you never know. Hell no.
So, like, I hope it's more, like y'all said, Dangerously in Love, more hip-hop. I could use that kind of music from Beyonce.
I could use that right now.
Yeah, I could use that in life.
I need some R&B too, though.
Yeah.
I'm not going to lie. And that you said that, I stumbled upon an R&B playlist on Apple, and it was so fire.
Oh, I have to send you mine.
It was nobody that I knew.
Oh.
It was one of them ones, like, up and coming.
Oh, not like the one you sent me.
Yeah, not like, yeah. These people was kind of like new, and I was like, you know, all the songs wasn't fire, but it was like some heat on that bitch. I worked to that shit. I was like, all right, we got some good hands. But yeah, I think Beyonce gonna do good this week. You know, I don't know what else is dropping. It's been a while. Haven't heard the Beehive in a while.
That's what I'm not ready for.
Yeah, you know they coming Thursday.
Oh Lord,
they've been quiet for a while though, so I can't even be mad at them. Like, let's get a Beehive day time. Like,
no, they gonna be thirsty though.
Yeah, as they should.
I hear them buzzing now, about a mile away.
Wait till tomorrow, and they drop the next day. Oh yeah, next day at midnight.
It's gonna drop at 12:01. Mm-hmm. Oh my god, this is fire from the damn Beehive. No.
She ain't even listened to a song yet. It's right. The coldest shit ever.
Queen.
Looking at.
Yeah. I just hope it's hip hop. Let me see what those things. Cause she did drop the track list, Plastic Off the Sofa. That sound like it could be fire. I don't know. I know I ain't gonna like America Has a Problem.
Was about to be some super woke stuff.
That song
feeling like the album about to be, cause that song, that single she dropped.
What was the name of that one? Break My Soul.
Yeah,
that song here. So
that's
like
borderline.
I'm That Girl, Cozy. Alien Superstar. That sound kind of freaky.
What? That's what you got from that?
Yeah, that sound freaky.
Okay.
Cuff It. That sound like it. I don't know. That could go either way. Energy. Break My Soul. Church Girl. Boy, I love the motherfucking Church Girls.
Oh, my God. Ooh.
I feel like Church Girl is
going
to be fire.
Love Me and Church. It's, yeah. She should have put 2 U's in it, like Church. She is from Houston. She could have did that. Yeah, she could have did that easily. Plastic Off the Sofa.
Thick might be sweet.
Virgo Groove, Move, Heated, Thick, THIQUE. Mm.
That's why I said thick might be sweet. Thick. I like the spelling.
Yeah, that spelling is hard.
Thick.
All Up in Your Mind, America Has a Problem, Pure / Honey, and Summer Renaissance.
Dream is on a lot of this.
Summer Renaissance sounds super, super break my soul-ish, yeah. Come together-ish. She's sitting on a horse, a clear, I don't know, it's not clear, but I don't know what kind of described this horse. A crystal horse, there
crystal,
we go.
Yeah.
I knew they had a word. yeah, she's sitting on a, body looks amazing.
Yeah.
She looks great.
Yeah, she looked like she on an ice figure.
Yeah.
Beyonce Cole.
Moms
that's
be
sure.
having that body on
them. I'll say, so Hit-Boy produced the song Thick, so I can guarantee you that's going to be a hip-hop sound the song. And that's going to sound fire.
Might even be some ass-shaking type music.
I'm here for that.
Me too.
It was something I was about to say that I forgot, actually. I forgot what I was going to say. Church Girl, Break My Soul. Yeah. Joe, you a Beyonce fan?
Nah.
You listen to a lot of different music.
Yep.
I seen you put that list out the other day. You was in your bag.
Oh, on Mellow.
Yeah, on Mellow Post.
Yeah.
Moving on from Beyonce, Queen B. Oh, this is what I want to say. Did you hear Tink's new song?
No, I don't listen to Tink. I can't get her voice.
We're going to play some of Tink's song.
Oh, my God. Here we go.
We're going to play some of Tink's song.
I got to look and see. I think I saved it.
Tink has a new song called Goofy.
I ain't save it, but I did hear it.
Oh, shoot.
This, all y'all goofy. Brand new Tink. Goofy. You hear the hit maker on the production.
Sounded like Sean.
Normally I'd have blocked you from my phone. Normally I'd already be up at my sister's house. I'd barely even notice you were gone. Yeah. Wouldn't even have the energy to fucking cuss you out. I guess it's different cause that you got me goofy. Halfway past stupid. This fool got me foolish. What am I doing? I guess that you got me goofy. Halfway past stupid. So fucking ruined, and it ain't nothing I'm doing about it. I ought to be ashamed. Words that just can't explain. My mama, she ain't raised me like that. Me like that. I ought to.
How old is she?
Mad as fuck.
How old is she? Because why is she?
Shaq is pissed.
I love the fuck out of that song.
I bet you do.
I was like, oh,
you,
shit,
you love
man.
You a goofy, too. So oh. I bet you do.
Oh, man. Hey, hold on. This is my favorite part right here. This one.
Let's be dumb as a bitch. Boy, I don't never do nothing like this.
Wait, hold on,
from
hold on,
the way that he punished the pussy, I'm loving it. I don't be right. My mama, she ain't raised me like
part.
That. Me like that. I must be dumb as a bitch. Boy, I don't never do nothing like this. Just from the way that he punished the pussy, I'm
oh
loving it.
Goodness.
I don't be running from dick. No, we got paper, them numbers is big. But I'm a real woman, I come with my shit. Usually I'm independent, but damn, he be in it in love with his tongue on my clit.
Oh my God.
Tink in the motherfucking bag.
Oh my goodness.
Kush.
Yeah, I saved it already.
We see what you about to be banging with your hand out the window.
As soon out as
the
we window. Get out of here.
That art sound.
Listen,
no, ain't no song. Hand out the window. It's going to be this wrist.
Listen, ain't nothing like.
Go watch.
Ain't nothing like banging some R&B.
Trying
banging
to track
it.
All the goose.
Yeah, when, oh, you bangs in the trunk too.
You banging some R&B.
Oh,
a car washed? Banging R&B in the summer sound with your car wash is like
literally,
the great. Because people always look like,
goodness.
What is he listening? Like, this
what is, that?
Is jamming to that. You hear it.
You see it.
Either, when I leave the car wash, I either listen to some R&B or some 90s rap.
Oh, my goodness.
It had me in a different bag. When
I didn't know
out.
There was
I
a leaving
to,
the car called the car
some
wash
local
playlist.
Music, some local, like, bang bang shit. Or.
You hear what he be on?
So you turn into a lover boy, and you turn into
it's
well, I don't know. You just said cherish the day. That's like two different ends of the spectrum.
Two songs I play as soon as I pull off Midlothian out of the car wash every time.
No, I turn into a lover boy. Like
I'm
you turn
into
myself.
A lover boy. You turn into a lover rat. Boy hood rat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No. Not even hood rat. A hood nigga.
Yes. I'm
gonna either come Area F or Side A.
I mean, when I say 90s rap, it's like some Too Short. So I'm either coming like.
Yeah, so y'all turning into lover hood rats.
Like, since the year started, I've been in this whole like local bag. Like, I got this crazy playlist of everybody.
Well, you cut a lot of their heads too, don't you?
That's dope.
Not really. I mean, it's one group, but I mean, I listen to everybody, like, just like you. I love Deja Doll. I do.
Yeah, that's my girl. Shout out to Deja Doll.
Everybody know that.
That's dope.
So, like, I listen to a whole bunch of a little bit of everything. It just depends on what type of mood I'm in today.
All right.
But I know I'm going to listen to that Sade sometimes.
Y'all want to hit this Chris Brown? Let's go to Chris Brown. You want to do the Chris Brown right now?
Yes.
Let's do the Chris Brown. Chris Brown. So, he's on tour right now with Lil Baby. We talk a lot about Chris Brown up here. It just so happens.
We love Chris Brown.
Yeah, we like Chris Brown. Like, I might sound like I don't like him, but I do like Chris Brown. I will say that. And I love this, because if you got somebody that'll pay for it.
Why not?
Why right. not? So he has a meet and greet, and a lot of his pictures went viral just recently of him taking pictures with people. And the ticket for the meet and greet is $1,000. Now, I know up front that sounds crazy, right? But you're not just getting a picture.
Right.
You're getting the ticket that's all the way up front. You're in the front end of the front is. I think you might get even a meal, dinner, drinks. You know, I think all that's included in the package. And you get the picture. Would I pay for something like this? No.
Okay, because it's Chris Brown.
No, I don't care who it is.
So if it was Young Miami.
No.
You are a lie. You definitely dropping that bag on Carisha.
$1,000?
You definitely believe you.
For that price, I wish Dave Chappelle tickets was like that. Like I could go.
So you would pay that for Dave Chappelle?
I already sat up front, so I know I'm going to go get a pitcher and a meal and drinks and shit too. Oh yeah, I would have did it.
You would do that for Dave Chappelle?
It's only $300 cheaper than what I paid anyway.
You would definitely do it for Carisha.
On my life, I'm not paying Carisha $1,000 to take a picture with her.
Arthur, please.
Like you, I'm gonna be honest. You got more chance of me paying that for a male than to go take a picture with a woman.
So
I'm gonna be honest. I'm still not gonna do it. But if you think I'm gonna do it, don't think it's gonna be with Carisha.
Okay, but what if the concert's not just her? It's her and some other people.
No, I can't see myself paying $1,000 for no concert. I turn down free concerts.
I guess.
All the time.
I don't believe you, but okay.
You don't think I come out? If Chit was here, he would tell you.
I'm still stuck on the Young Miami thing. Because you like
I can't even. Low-key. I like her, but I'm not even paying to go to her concert.
Wow. You hear this, Young Miami? You know she listen, right? Listen, you know she listen, right?
You know, the stand is some play shit. Let's be real. I'm not going to see City Girls at a concert by myself.
No.
Mm-hmm. That's never happening.
No.
Like,
no.
No.
I don't care how much I love JT. No.
No. Like,
no.
I can't even name five songs.
Wow.
No.
I'm still rapping Act Up. Like, I like her, but like, let's be real. Like,
wow.
I'd be like, keep performing Act Up. Like, that's cool. That's all I really wanted to hear.
I ain't mad at it. I'm not mad at this at all. And the pictures are so dope. Like, it's not a regular.
Well, that's because he looked like he fucking every one of them.
Right. I mean, that makes it
bigger
worth the money.
Than average, you know, getting picked up.
Exactly.
By Chris Brown.
Yeah, he behind them, taking it. They all look like.
It's giving like.
Somebody said that's how you know how
it's
toxic.
It's giving Sadie's Hawkins type.
Somebody said picture. You know how toxic he is because he made every person look like the love of his life.
I love it. Yeah, I pay for
that. Look at this.
They look like high school sweethearts.
If that's my bitch. You didn't gave this man $1,000 and you.
You would be mad at that picture.
Where are you putting this picture at?
In my office.
Yeah. Because you ain't.
Because that bitch should never make it in my house.
Never make it in my house.
Let this nigga put his dick on your butt.
That's basically right.
You're
right.
You got me fucked up.
You got me.
Like, oh my goodness. Y'all are absurd. Like,
Hey, that's another one.
On me, like, what?
Wow.
What you doing?
What the fuck is this shit? Another one of them.
Oh, my goodness. Hey. Y'all are...
You trying to put that up next to Black Jesus?
It's
yeah, right.
Picture,
yeah, right.
Like,
yeah, right.
No, you ain't about to put that to our picture next to a linear aquarium.
It's
going to kill you.
It's not a this. Picture.
Hey, in my case, you're not putting next to that New York skyline
picture. You better not put that next to the Gateway Clipper picture. I'll kill
oh
you.
My goodness. Whatever. It's a damn picture. Whatever.
Not next to my Black Moses.
Ain't no way.
Nah, you better move. It was out of all the pictures, it was one guy that actually took a picture and they did like a
yo,
a handshake. I would hope.
Nah, show. They did like a side, like they was
like in jail,
like a jail picture. They took like a jail picture.
Definitely a jail.
Wow.
Yeah, that's a jail pose.
This is a favorite cousin picture.
Go next to that Cavs background, bro.
Like this chick right here, she can't have a nigga. He is literally holding her up, her legs wrapped around her.
She do.
That's the one I was talking about.
That's a tiny bit too far, but I would still take it and you just never see it. I'll put it in my office.
I'm going to see it because they posted it online.
Every single hey,
I would have been pissed. If she had a nigga, she oh don't know more.
Fam, I just got a headache just thinking
picture.
About.
Over a picture.
If this was my chick in the world seeing this, and my homie's like, nigga, Chris had your girl up in the
baby the
boy? Yeah, in the baby
the
boy?
Melvin?
In the...
It was not the Melvin. His arms are not under his legs.
It's damn near the Melvin.
This is like a...
Man.
If you go look at Melvin...
He held his daughter like this.
His behind her arms with them on her shoulders so he has grip and movement.
This is how Chris Brown holds his daughter. Okay.
Okay, but so, this is how Chris Brown getting them guts too.
Oh my goodness. Like, okay.
If this was my bitch and then I got to deal with my niggas... Like, yo, no Chris Mash.
She got her money.
Come on,
worth.
Man. First of all, my girl can't even come up and tell me that it's $1,000 to take a picture with Chris Brown and think that's about to go down. Bitch, we is late on the light bill. What you mean? We got past due bills and you about to pay $1,000 to take a picture?
Oh, man, I wasn't goodness. Paying $200 to take a picture with Gary Owens and I have front table teeth. No way.
Come on, man.
$200 to see Gary Owens.
I'm not even waiting in line for the free picture.
Oh, my goodness.
She was like, I just want to go get a picture. I said, for $200, nigga.
And I can't believe it. I mean, I'm all for, you know, I can't believe another dude wanted this picture, though. But it's dope. You know what I'm saying?
It is dope.
I think he got his picture on the flex side. Like, hey, baby, you know I'm the only nigga in line that paid this band, too. You know,
I'm sure they thought he was gay.
Okay.
Do you get points for that? If you was in line and you seen another dude in line, he get points?
No.
Oh, there you go, Kush.
Hey, I mean, maybe that's what he thought. Oh, I mean, okay. He got them fat ass jeans on, though. You don't know what that nigga was thinking. He from Warren.
Oh, my.
This one right here in the red is extremely happy.
Yes.
She is extremely happy.
That's the homecoming picture.
I've seen
right here.
And he got a handful of titty. Her nigga beat her ass.
That is not fucking funny. That's not fucking funny, man.
Oh my goodness.
And she got them the Catwoman.
Them
nails.
Claws.
Oh my
God.
I'm hey, listen. Killing you.
Can you imagine? Can you imagine, like, see, some of these is a little PG. Like this chick right here that just got the side-by-side, she probably thought that was it. Then you go home and you see the other ones that hit the net of him
and
actually.
Mad as hell that you didn't do your freaky picture.
Yeah, like, you like, damn, this nigga could have picked me up. And I was wondering what the church hug.
Because, you know, she wanted to bust it wide open, but she wanted to be, you know, the first one.
No, this is a picture of I Got a Man. What?
Oh, get out of here. Yep.
That's what that kind of picture. Now, my
y'all
girl could take this
that.
Picture.
Yep.
I know. That's cool. That's cool. For I know sure. That's your boy, but you know you got to, hey.
I thought y'all would be mad that he resting his head on hers.
Nah, after seeing the other ones, I'll take this one. Like, because I know, like, oh, Chris, it could have got worse.
So she can blow that one up and post
it. No, it's still not. Okay. This at your job. This at your desk at work.
What?
This is what you...
Wow.
Put this next to the picture of your work husband.
Wow. Work husband.
Y'all got him.
No, we do not.
You work from home, so...
Even when I was in the office, I did not. Whatever.
Hey, it'd be...
Just because you smashing everybody at the...
Come on, man. I am one with them. Come on, man. Ain't nothing more funny than seeing a married person, married people be having, like, work husband, work wife relationships. Like, damn, y'all in here.
Like, I bet you... I know you know.
Yeah, I mean, you just watch it, you know. Anything else for Chris Brown? So, because you letting your wife or girl do that? $1,000?
Of course not.
Joe?
No.
What?
So you letting your nigga pay $1,000, Shaq, to go take a picture next to Megan Thee Stallion. She bent over.
Yes. Swear to goodness.
I can't say what I normally say.
I was going to suggest that she bent over, but you said it first. Like, if he paid $1,000.
But that's because you know that he not about to smash. Chris might fuck around and fuck one of y'all. Chris might hit. Chris,
that is terrible.
Chris.
No.
I'm going to just keep it a bean. Chris smacking you. Like. like he invite. He's going to invite you to the
back. I don't even do light skin, so no, he's not.
All right. He do that backflip.
Chris going to do a line off my shoulder.
You know you into that.
A bump off your shoulder?
Yeah.
You know, that's her shit. Oh, my goodness.
You know, that's her shit.
Hit the 123?
No, thank you.
Right.
Bump on the shoulder.
No, thank you.
And she gonna, you going to be like, no, do a bump off my bump.
Bye, man. You know what? I don't even want the picture no more.
Hey, my dude going to hit me up and was like, man, I was laughing just as hard as you when that part happened, man. I was like, thank you, man, because they did not laugh like me. hold up. So we got the bottom of that. Let's go to this church robbery.
Man.
Let's go to this church robbery. So, like, if you haven't heard, Bishop Brooklyn Lamor Miller Whitehead, anybody with that many names cannot be trusted. Cannot be trusted. Was robbed while preaching live on camera. Was robbed. So when I first heard this, just like everybody else, I was like, damn, like them niggas robbed a church. I'm like, niggas is going to hell. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's wild. Like,
right.
Even when I seen the video, I still was like, it looked a little weird, but damn, that's still fucked up. Then the report come of what they got.
Man, they hit a lick.
It said that they was robbed of $400 million worth of jewelry. And then I'm like,
ain't no fucking way, boy. Boy, ain't no way, boy.
Ain't no way.
Ain't no
boy,
way.
Ain't no way, boy.
Like, no way.
Boy, ain't no way, boy.
I'm not going for it.
Ain't no.
I don't know why that place was. I'm not going for it. Oh. I got it. I had to take a deep dive into this whole pastor to realize, to understand why he got $400 million worth of jewelry on.
But they knew.
Yeah, the robbers knew.
I mean, like, his congregation and them knew too.
Okay, so this is what I came, the conclusion I came to. He sells dope.
400 million or 400?
Wow.
400,000, I'm sorry. 400,000 worth of jewelry. He sells dope.
Yeah, but I mean, you can see that.
He sells dope.
That church look like it's, this is just church.
He's not, it's not a real church. It's not a congregation type of church. I went through the Instagram. I didn't see one picture of a church.
So he just on camera all the time.
He's just on, I think he's just a camera church.
So he getting tithes and offerings to the Cash App.
So he doing live church.
Yeah, he's doing live church. Like
and they
here.
Cash
like,
happening.
They gotta be Cash App.
They gotta be.
They Cash Apping him they tithes and offering.
And he going to buy $75,000 watches.
And $150,000 chain.
God bless him.
And got robbed for that shit on live.
It says at the time of the robbery, him and his wife were wearing more than 1 million in jewels and gold.
Together?
Yeah, it was a $75,000 Rolex watch, another $75,000 watch, a $25,000 ruby and diamond ring, another $25,000 diamond ring, $25,000 pair of earrings, $20,000 diamond cross, another $20,000 ring. Like, what are we doing? What are we doing? This, what are we doing, man?
So they cash happening, he buying birds, flipping the money, buying jewelry, and going back on live on Sunday, preaching. That's what you telling me.
Oh, my goodness. Basically.
Look at him.
He's sharp.
Look at dude. Sharp.
Casket sharp. You niggas are crazy.
That's hey, who I feel like is behind there preaching. Like a nigga that's talking.
Look.
Yeah, look at his suit. Like, he's Gucci. Look,
it's Gucci.
Look at this.
That ring. That ring is nuts.
Look at this Fendi.
That's Gucci.
He looks like a rapper.
Yes.
Come on, man.
$200,000 Look at the nigga behind him. Gold chain.
Where is he at? She has a drink in her hand. He's wearing a bandana.
Right. This is.
This nigga is at Liv. Look, man, like. Yeah, wow. Live on Saturday and at church on Sunday.
This hell nigga no. is at Live. Oh my God. He has a Cuban link chain. Like, come on, man. Look at this nigga. I hate niggas, man. Like, I don't believe you, bro. I don't believe nothing that come out this man's mouth.
Nothing.
Like, you sell birds. Period. You got a million and some fake followers on Instagram.
I'm sorry, it's not a church. It's not a religious thing line that man can say that I would believe.
None. Nothing. Your name might as well be Creflo Dollar.
Bro, he own Shade Room arguing.
Arguing. Mm-mm. Calling a woman big. He was like, look at you, just Biggie Big.
Just big. Biggie.
What?
He was calling her Biggie the entire time.
You a pastor. You a bishop. Mm-mm-mm. You're definitely Baptist.
Looking like Flavor Flav.
Come on, man.
Mm-mm.
Come on, dog.
Y'all need to stop going to the online churches.
The scroll over when you see him at the church hit the flow. Well, that's probably his crib with some banners up. Right. Whatever. What is he renting, a suite? Either way it goes. Like, I don't know.
It's Buddy in the back for me.
Buddy in the back didn't even move. He like,
he just like he the one that set it up. He didn't move, facts. Not once. He set this whole robbery up.
I am so anxious to see how this plays out. Now, listen, if this man is all the way legit, he's not. So I don't care.
Right.
I'm not even. Way. I don't care. He's not, because I don't see a pastor buying that kind of shit.
No.
Like, at least hide it from me, nigga.
A real pastor would have started praying. He wouldn't have been all right. He would have just closed his eyes and started praying.
Listen, I'm all for praying. But sometimes you need to keep your
eyes low.
Sometimes you need to keep your eyes open.
They come in there strapped like that, get low.
Hey, sometimes you need to keep your eyes open,
Shaq. You're peeking.
You praying, keep your eyes, pray with your eyes open.
Oh,
dude.
Man.
Because you need to see what's going on.
And it's crazy because as soon as dudes start going down to the ground, his chain touched first. That's how you know it's
right.
That's how you know he got a gang
cheerio. The motherfucking chain.
That motherfucking thump too.
They was in there like, give me all that.
All
shit.
Of that.
All of that, nigga.
All of that.
In the name of Jesus. Give me all of
look
that.
Look at dude right here. He just like, yeah, get all of that.
Get all of that. I feel him.
Don't forget to break me off. They didn't even put a gun to him or nothing.
Nothing.
Walk straight past me.
He ain't trying to like sit still or nothing. He just sitting there like,
nope.
He didn't, dang, change. It's he didn't crazy. Change his mind.
Oh. First of all,
I know what y'all doing.
They had a goddamn hall.
Okay.
They run out of suite.
No.
Empty suite. That's where people take pictures.
It was four masked men that came into the church and took all the jewelry from the dope dealing pastor.
He going to be arguing with you next.
Like, for real, like, right. Right. I hope you do hear this. No, I don't, because
You ain't trying to tussle.
Beef with no kingpin. They got reach.
Man, he obviously got it.
For real, this, like, to me, his name should really be Creflo Dollar. Oh, then he said that they didn't know there were cameras. So as they left the church, he went chasing after them. Well, well. Can you imagine that next sermon?
Man.
I wish I had some church organs right now. I'll fuck it up.
Man.
He asked for a little extra.
And listen, them niggas went in there like,
I took it because God told me to. And guess what? God helped me do everything. Stupid. I did everything. Hey, look, when I get out, I'm going to steal a police car.
God told me to take that necklace up off of my brother.
He told me to take all them necklaces all off of
him. Don't forsake him. Hand it over.
Oh, my goodness. A total of $1 million in jewelry?
Yeah.
In a three-person church?
That's wild.
That's crazy.
Who let him in?
Had to be the into their hotel room.
Had to be dude to the left.
Who opened the hotel door?
Who opened the hotel door?
God damn it.
Yeah, it had to be. You're right, because it had to be an inside job. Because how'd they get the key to that room?
So we just said it's a room?
Yeah, this ain't no real church. Like, because yeah, it got the, it's a room. They rent it with the backdrop.
That's their backdrops.
No, they put them backdrops.
Yeah, that's right.
They
backdrops.
Brought the backdrops in.
Remember when we used to go to Jits? They used to have the money with the two Escalades? Yeah. That's all.
Oh, they got a picture booth. They got a picture booth.
Picture booth. Right.
No, for real.
Yeah, for real. They got two of them.
A dude brought his own podium.
A couple curtains. Boom.
And he got that podium from like
a thrift store.
A thrift store garage sale.
That motherfucker 24 carats.
Oh, he got it dipped.
Yeah, look at that. They should have took that too, shit.
Walking out of somewhere with a gold podium is wild.
Walking in somewhere with an AR
is
wild.
Man. They walked out and said, God bless.
Not if God told you to.
Right.
I'd rather walk out with the 24 karat gold podium then.
Moving on from the dope Dylan pastor, man. There's been a lot of TV is coming back. Shows is coming back. Movies are coming out. And it was one show that I really wanted, I kind of hounded y'all on watching, and that was Rap Shit. So let me ask y'all, before we get into Rap Shit, are y'all a fan of Insecure?
You're good. Absolutely. I was so sad when it ended. Like,
I've never seen that.
Oh, Kush, that add that too. You gotta watch Beyonce, and you gotta watch Issa Rae first. What's it called again? You just said it.
Insecure.
Rap Shit?
Insecure. Watch Insecure first.
Yeah.
Okay.
If you didn't watch...
That's dope as fuck.
So you did watch Rap Shit, though? Mm-hmm. Okay. So you really don't understand... Did you like Rap Shit?
Yeah, I did.
Okay. But, Joe, did you watch Insecure?
Nope.
Okay. I don't know if you're going to watch it. But if you do, it's a good show. So
it's Insecure, on Netflix?
No, it's on HBO.
Okay.
It went on for 5 seasons. Issa Rae wrote it. And she ended it on her own. We talked about that on here many of times. But she has a new show that she started called Rap Shit on HBO. Same kind of format, 30 minutes. I think it's going to be 8 episodes long. I really wanted you guys to watch it. I'm glad you guys did. The show is about two girls who come together, two friends, who come together to form a rap group that live in Miami. First thoughts on the show, Shaq?
I think it's dope. It's different. I was looking for another
episode
love story from Issa Rae. But okay. I'm glad she took another avenue.
I do want to say it's a comedy-based show as well. So you got to, like, keep that in mind that it's comedy. It's not like a drama. But Insecure was also a comedy too, though. But it still had all that, the other aspects of life in there too.
Right.
Kush, what did you think of it?
I mean, I thought it was sweet for real. I do like, you know, that it's funny with a little bit of drama in it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And I don't know, like, it's gonna be sweet. I like it. For it to be the first episode, I think it's going
to
be dope.
Well, it dropped 2 episodes. I don't know if you were able to watch.
I didn't get to watch the second one because I was on my way here.
Plus, yeah, the second one is what got me hooked.
Yeah, it gets.
If you just seen the first one, the second one, you're going to be like, oh, I'm all the way in. All right. Because it really turned up. But if you haven't had a chance to watch it, it's going to be one of them shows.
Unless you're a broke bitch like me, and you can't watch it. Art called me a broke bitch because I told him I don't have HBO. So Art must be sharing his HBO password. If you want to watch it, he's sharing his password.
I stole it from a gang of family members. So.
Yeah, it's not mine.
I got all my free apps.
I didn't, just because I called you a broke don't mean I ain't broke.
So you broke too.
Yeah, like, I just said you.
Oh, no, you call me broke ass, I think.
Yeah, I ain't call you no bitch. Don't do that. I said broke ass. I know, it take one to know one.
Like you went.
But they say the show is not 100% based off the City Girls, but it kind of is.
Yeah, and I'm mad you told me that beforehand because I was looking too hard for it.
Is it?
Yeah.
Now I really want to watch.
But if you already see it, it's two friends.
Right.
One of them wanted to be a rapper. Right. If you know the City Girl, JT wanted to be a rapper. Mm-hmm. And she convinced Young Miami to join in. You also know JT went to jail for scamming.
Right.
If you watch the show, you see the one girl.
What's showing the credit card?
They kind of just switched. That's why I said it's not all the way based.
Okay.
Because the girl that's, and I don't want to tell the episode, but the girl that's doing that, you know what I mean?
Like, yeah.
She was the one that was rapping. So it right. switched a little bit, but it's fairly based off of them.
Oh, yeah.
And I don't know how much it's going to, but P is an executive producer from their label.
Yeah, okay.
So, and the girl kind of sound like her, you know what I mean? It kind of showed real life, like, the real life struggle of...
They, like, come up.
Of come up. You see her baby dad on the same, you know, the one girl baby dad. Mm-hmm.
Right.
You know, at first...
And he's so more adamant on he coming up than...
Yeah, but right. but you ain't see the second one, though, so you really don't know what's going to happen on the second one.
Okay.
But you seeing what he did. Yeah. I like that in just... down him so much.
Right.
And you know, because it
was starting off that way.
Yeah. It's not like a man bashing show, mm-mm. even though it's women in it. You know what I mean? Like, it still was uplifting, you know, other dudes too. So that's why I really fucked with it. Because I wasn't going to
see that second episode.
I wasn't going to sit through no man bashing shit. Like,
Issa dope though. Like, she get you just enough and then she'll ease up and smooth it out. Yep. She's so dope.
Yep. She's so dope. You could, she a professional, man.
Yeah. She the shit.
She the shit. Like, protect Issa at all costs, man.
Yes.
For real. Like, we got to start watching this shit support because she, you know, she using black cast, black people on the set. Like, we talked about it on the show more than one time that Issa has really done a lot for black people in the filming industry as well as other people. But for her to be so young and not as rich.
And she's so unapologetic, like.
Yeah,
she let it be known, like, oh no, I'm pro black.
Pro black.
She ain't trying to conform to no white ways to fit in. I love Issa. She's so dope.
And I like Issa because sometimes, like, people get too artsy for me.
Right.
I'm all for art and being, like, having to think what this is.
Yeah, but I don't want you to go too far to where I got to. Like, I don't even understand what
the hell is going on. What am I watching? You know what I mean? Like, who are you connecting to when you go too deep?
Yeah, so, like, who are you trying to reach at this point?
I like how Issa, she found the line to be like, throw some art shit in there for you, but I'm also
hood.
I'm hood.
Yeah.
I'm hood. Cause you seen the sex scenes that was in it.
Yeah.
Like, that second one, that shit was like, that second sex scene, I almost hit the homies up like, hey, this shit lit. Like,
you better get on that second episode.
Yeah, that second one was, that motherfucker was lit. Like, I thought they were about to show some cat.
Cat.
I mean.
It was like a monster ball, like.
It was, hey, that shit was lit. Like,
it was lit, but calm down.
Yeah, we can calm down. I don't like, and this is going to turn me to my next thing. I don't like sex in shows and movies. I'm not a fan of it.
Why?
Because I don't like to, and it's probably because I'm weak, but I don't like to be sitting there with a girl or a female or whatever, and then we on the couch and like a exotic, super exotic sex scene come up.
That's the best time for it to.
Because now I want to fuck.
Oh, my God.
Now I want to fuck. Like.
My God.
Now I'm horny.
Like, you don't even want to watch the movie no more or nothing.
Yeah, I don't want to do nothing. Now I'm thinking about fucking. Like,
What's up?
What's up?
We should reiterate this.
Yeah, like.
Oh, my goodness.
So, like, I sometimes won't even look at it. I'll be like, you know what I'm saying? Because like,
you just can't control yourself.
Because I don't want to be altered in that way.
Oh, my goodness. Wow.
So, take it all out. Like
they don't. It could. Or,
so, sex things don't get you hot or bothered? Nothing? I ain't saying all of them, but.
No, I can't think of one that did. Like, I'd be like, oh, that's lit. Kush. But it ain't, I don't be like, pause
this. Sex ain't never made you want to go fuck.
When I was like younger.
Oh, nah. Okay.
Grow up.
Nah, I need to grow up. Okay. Joe, I need to grow up.
No.
Yo. No.
Joe,
it
what?
Do that to you too?
Yeah.
Thank you. Like.
Maybe it's. I'm not
it's y'all.
I don't know.
It's y'all. Like, I don't, I just be like. Titties bouncing. Like, I ain't sitting here to watch some. I could go watch a porno.
Wow. It don't be that deep towards the porno, though.
It sometimes it do, though.
But and it don't.
That's what turned me off from Power. I stopped watching Power. I never finished Power because of that.
See, Power's sex scenes weren't even all that to make you that excited.
No, they wasn't. No, but it was like point. It was just like forced. I was like, another sex scene. I'm tired of seeing these sex scenes with Angela Valdez.
You ever read the, you know, like the black novels?
So like you gotta
look at like I don't care about Raul and Damian with the dreads, that's dark skin.
Oh my goodness.
You gotta just look at it like that. Like they writing the shows kind of like how people write the books. And you know, you that's be midway through the chapter six and right before.
So you was reading sex books, bro?
Right, he was definitely reading a Zane book.
Killed the plug.
You was reading Zane?
He was definitely reading Zane.
His bitch was worried about.
Yeah, see, that sound like a Zane. That sound like a Zane book. Yeah, you've been reading it.
You ain't never seen a cartel or nothing like that? Like, you ain't never read it?
No, I'm not reading that shit.
Mm-mm.
Damn. How?
I just haven't. Let me ask you all this. Y'all watch P.
Saga?
Y'all yes, watch P-Valley?
Yes, I watch
P-Valley.
No,
I'm trying
P-Valley.
To let it be over first so I can watch it all at once.
Okay, good. Don't let social media sway you.
I'm not watching P. No, I'm not watching P-Valley at all.
Why? Because social media is
no,
you
I didn't finish the first season.
It is not
because
that
of that reason, though. My reason of like, I'm watching all this ass and titties at the strip club.
You missing out,
and
on
I'm supposed to go to bed.
You missing out on good shows because you can't control yourself. Like,
at least I know who I am.
Get a grip. Get a grip.
I know who I am.
Yeah, nah. With P-Valley, like, and then, I like the first episode. So, like, I mean, the first season. So, I'm trying to let all the episodes come on because people be blowing it on Facebook for me.
So you can sit
there
and binge.
I'll do that too.
Yeah, so I can just sit there and watch all the shows.
But then this is how I knew this last one was bad. I've seen a lot of people talking about this last sex scene in the last episode.
Yeah, I did too. And I didn't watch it yet, but.
And I got a text from somebody at 11:45 last night that said, I just watched P-Valley and the sex scene made me real uncomfortable.
Poor baby.
A woman said that?
A woman said this. Oh. And I was like.
It's two men.
But it's.
Yeah, the scene she's talking about is men.
Yeah. I've seen some memes going around. I don't know. I'm cool. That's what they want. That's fine. I just don't have to partake in that.
Wow.
But I'm the same on both ends, though.
Okay.
I'm not just like, oh, it's a gay scene.
Yeah,
I don't want to watch
it. Because
you
just can't control yourself.
Because, yeah.
Right.
No, I'm not agreeing to that. No, we're not doing that.
That's what it's given. Like, no.
Hey, man.
That's.
You walked yourself into that, right?
I did. And you ain't help. I thought you didn't feel me, but you like,
man,
no, I watch all that shit and don't feel nothing.
Well, no, because
I watch that shit, then go play Madden.
Me and my partner, we actually watch pornos together. So that means nothing. We in the middle
and then
of the
go
series.
Eat.
Yeah.
Y'all watch pornos together and don't even fuck.
So we might not.
See, because they can control themselves.
That's a whole different conversation.
I mean, we a little, you know, we a little.
Watching porno and not. Doing anything after.
Not saying we're not going to eventually do it.
But they don't have to, like, get
we
right to it.
Don't have to do it right.
Start ripping each other's clothes off.
What's the timetable? Break this down for me.
Hour, two.
All right, so we started watching a porno at 8 p.m.
Mm-hmm. We might take a break at, like, 9.
To do what?
Have a couple drinks, snack, maybe watch some more, and then here it goes.
See, it's a build-up. That's control. Learn it.
Because we know after we start, we gonna go and then shit, our night is
Joe,
over.
Joe, what you said?
All right. So you're just watching porno like for the scenes, like for the, you know, what are you watching it for? Like, because it's supposed to be an end game. So You go and do your everyday life. And
so,
then, no, I mean, we sit there, we find, you know, a good one, a lengthy good one.
How long is a lengthy good one?
29. 28 minutes.
That's specific as heck.
No, that's where we at. He got one.
He like, he know it's
29. I've seen a couple of them on there.
We go through them and we save them. So it'd be like, hey, you know, get home.
What website?
It fluctuates. You know, it might be XNXX. Sometimes Pornhub. It fluctuates. X Hamster.
You ever watch?
You never mentioned.
What is it called? Spank Bang?
I'm X Videos. I'm OG.
They be.
Grow.
That quality be weak.
That's
important.
You want to watch them 1999.
Right. Like, do they even upload newer videos?
Yeah, they do, man.
Niggas on there like 80 now.
Nah, y'all slipping. y'all ain't been there in a while.
They got gray coochie hair on X videos.
Right. Y'all, right. Hey, listen. Y'all ain't been there in a while.
Everything is geriatric, but okay. Enjoy it.
Go ahead, give us your sites.
That's my site, Spank Bang, I think it's called.
You think?
Maybe. One moment, please.
I'm sure as soon as you hit an S, it's gonna come up.
You
in
gotta
your phone.
Look. You gotta go to the
private tab.
Yeah, the private tab. How you get to the private tab again? Right here. Here we go.
God damn. God damn.
I forgot to close these. Shut up. Stop judging me. But where is my favorite? This is my favorite right here. Yep, Spank Bang. Yeah, that stays. I would never close this window because I don't want to like risk not losing it. I could watch this.
So you watch the same ones?
Sometimes.
If I need to
find something that I know is going to get the job done.
A new one every time.
No, but understand, this is a different situation. I watch this when I need to get the job. If I'm by myself.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
This Everybody is my go-to. Right. So
that
I don't close
know
this
it's
window.
Gonna hit. Sometimes I ain't got time to scroll.
My nigga just hit that private tab, y'all. And the amount of
open tabs. Stop telling my business.
That I just seen. Wow.
Stop telling my business, Art.
They don't make porn viruses like they used to. Because her phone wouldn't turn the fuck on ever again.
All right, okay. You're judging me.
Oh, man, this is fun.
Moving on.
God damn. I'm still mad at Kush over there. Like,
what? So don't get aroused during power porn?
No. We was not. Listen. That was a shot. Like, that sounded
control
wild.
Control yourself.
So you saying the part? We back to this. The porno start at 8. You watch it for a half an hour.
Intermission.
Mm-hmm. You go get something. You might eat or something.
We might eat. We might drink.
Take a couple
little,
shots.
We might
right.
clown a little bit.
So you eating like what? A snack or you might eat dinner?
A snack. I might eat. Dinner.
Might have leftovers.
So
right?
You might eat. So you're pause. You're eating dinner with a hard on. Because you just watched a half an hour of porn.
And a wet on, yes.
They letting it marinate.
Listen, I'm trying to eat, but it ain't dinner. I mean, I'm going to say that. Like,
I mean, I might get a lick.
Ain't nothing on the plate.
Ain't no way.
That's going to suffice this hunger that I got.
Man, bro, everything ain't got to be rest when you in right. the house already. We already here. Where you going? You ain't going nowhere.
I think Kush is saying he gets to the, like Joe said, the,
so he like,
the end game.
He want
to
build
up. He gets there.
The build up.
But he just comes, he gets there slower. Like,
women like the build up.
Right.
He like to be, like, he want to be like a volcano.
No, me, and I want to like dive speedy. Straight in, but I know that women like the build up.
I don't dive straight in because I'm a foreplay guy. But I'm saying that we watching porn, like I'm from the era of, you got to, you know what I'm saying? Before you. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm from that era. So, I ain't rushing, but I ain't just about to be sitting here watching a half an hour of porn. Like,
wow.
What are we doing?
You're not watching 30-second sex scenes, so we know you're not watching a half hour of porn.
Yeah, definitely. You're not watching Power because they have sex.
No, I'm not watching Power because it was forced sex scenes. They was some trash-ass sex scenes, but it was like, hey, y'all, we fucking again?
When Power first started, like,
it was fire.
That was all they did.
Yeah, but it was kind of, like, different a little bit. It was like, all right, you know what I'm saying?
They doing it.
I will say I appreciate Power for showing me Lala's titties. I've been wanting to see them titties since MTV.
Wow.
Before Carmella. So thank you, Power, for that. But other than that, man, I ain't that shit.
Wait, what?
You ain't want to see a lot of titties?
I mean, yeah, but I love the sex scenes in Power.
See?
I like Tasha's titties.
We seen them motherfuckers. Like, she just had a sex contract. Like,
yeah.
And she was getting boned out.
Everything she in, you got to show your titties.
She was getting boned everywhere. She might got a whole, the most bodies on there.
Oh, my God. Well, y'all knock it off.
All right. Just getting carried away.
Right. Ain't a porn podcast.
We did just go down a dark turn.
Like, literally.
We did, too.
I'm clipping all.
We're going to blame Shaq. She the one that came with all the fucking tabs.
Oh, my goodness.
That I ain't
you
gonna
got more
forget.
Tabs than a bartender.
I'm still in one of them tabs.
See, I got you.
More tabs than a bartender.
No.
And he hit the button.
No.
I don't even know where I want to go next. We're not going to hit all these.
Yeah, you're going to have to make a decision.
We?
Yeah.
You're
going to make an executive decision.
We got Emmitt Till and WWE.
Yeah, and it was the festival concert thing, too.
Oh, yeah.
I'd rather skip WWE.
Yeah, I'm cool with that.
Please.
All right, we off of that. I kind of, we can do these last two. So, we can end with Emmitt Till. Okay.
You sure? You don't want to end exciting?
All right.
Emmitt Till is a little bit sad.
Okay, we can do that. MGM Studios is putting out a full feature film about the life of Emmitt Till and his mother. For what?
I don't even get into stuff like that because I get triggered. So
triggered
I
like
don't
a motherfucker.
Even, I'm cool.
Who's Art asking pass. For this movie?
The trailer is really good, but it's a very touchy subject.
So. No, thank you. See, nah.
I mean, that's the type of movie that's going to make me go to work and you know where I work at. You know, my shop is.
Yeah.
I'm going to be seeing these people walk past my dough. They never speak anyway.
Joe, yeah. Is this a movie you want to see?
Oh, no. Hell no.
I don't know where, like, Whoopi Goldberg's in it.
She helped produce it, too.
I just don't see the need for this type of movie.
And there's no way there could be a happy ending.
Not at this
so
time
what
either.
Are we doing?
Are you doing it to educate people? Are you doing it to, like, I don't know the reasoning. Who's getting the money from this movie? It's so many questions I have about.
Yeah, all I have in my notes is questions and no's. I like the fact that Whoopi helped produce it, so maybe she might try to put something in it that'll, you know, enlighten it or let them at least let it go all the way so it ain't nothing hid to so people understand the story, but it's a whole bunch of no's and I don't know, it's for me.
Yeah, it'll probably be thorough because Whoopi has a hand in it, but that's all the reason why I don't want to see it. It's gonna
get too.
I'm
far.
Cool. I don't want no smoke with the.
It's gonna come
opposition.
Color purple times 20, and yeah.
Nah. Yeah.
I don't know. I watched the trailer earlier. I don't know how I feel about it.
I'm cool because I don't. Yeah. I really get triggered to the point where I'm like.
Especially after reading up on the whole situation, like, you know, knowing the actual story of.
Right. No. And that was a mistake because.
Exactly.
I just searched.
I was just curious.
I never did that.
Exactly. So, no.
I just searched on Twitter.
Just wanting to know.
Just to see what people were saying. It's pretty much everybody like, why do we need an Emmitt Till movie? Like,
no.
You better not take your ass to go see no Emmitt Till movie. Like.
We're still trying to heal.
We're still going through. We don't need a movie. We could turn on the news.
Right. Literally.
We can drive down the street.
Open our phone.
Look
boom.
What just happened in Akron.
Yeah, we live. Like, it might have changed. Like, you know, they're not hanging and doing exactly what this is, but we're still living it.
Right.
We don't need a movie, man.
No.
Like, I'm tired of them black movies like that.
Sir. We don't.
Like, I did appreciate, and I can't think of the one. What's the one we watched for movie night?
Joe.
Man. I can't think of the name of that one, but it's gonna hurt me.
What was it about?
Huh?
What was it about?
He was with, I don't even want to butcher it, so I'm not gonna. I was gonna fuck that shit all the way up. And I should remember the name.
Who was in it?
I don't even know who was in it. Oh, okay. Mm. Oh, Lakeith was in it.
Harder They Fall?
Nope. That was a good movie too.
That movie is good.
If you ever want to see a black cowboy movie.
Yeah, that movie cold.
I'm about to get the name of this movie right now, man. Judas and the Black Messiah.
Oh, I love that movie.
Yeah, I love
that's the kind of black movie y'all want to see.
I love that.
I watched it like for like a week.
I watched it twice. I'm about to watch that movie again. I'm definitely watching
that. That was dope as hell.
That's the type of black movie that I like to see. You know, even though it still was sad.
Right.
But
it was
empowering.
Yeah, it was definitely empowering.
It was empowering. This ain't going to be like, why?
It's gonna piss me off tomorrow. The next day, I'm gonna just wanna just smack some.
And don't get me wrong, Judas and the Black Messiah pissed me off
to the core,
even more.
But it still
empowered me.
Yeah,
and it still made me do more research and
reading
and read. Mm-hmm. Yeah, know what I should have already known. Mm-hmm. Like that's the type of movie that we needed. You know what I mean?
I was excited when that movie came out because I read the entire book, I read the Black Mafia book when I was in prison, and I read a book on the Black Panthers when I was in there. So when I seen that he was having the Fran Hampton movie, I was like, wow.
Yeah, that's dope. Cat. But see, the Black Messiah, in that movie, he died with, like, dignity.
No,
yeah.
Literally.
Emmitt Till. Like,
no problem.
They did him dirty.
Yeah, they did him dirty.
He went out sad. So I don't know. It's a hard no for me.
A different time of nigga hating. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And can I say something real quick?
Of course, Joe. Right.
So, like, the one thing I think that this can do, one or two things. Like, it can either enrage us to the point where it's like, why the hell isn't this lady in jail? Because she's still alive. Carolyn Bryant is still alive. Mm-hmm. Now, it's either going to enrage us or it's going to, you know, it's going to have, like, the social justice white folks that might get on the end where they might arrest her. You know, like, I mean, there's no statute of limitation. So she's part of a murder. You know, right. They found all this stuff about, you know, how the cops didn't arrest her. You know, they went into like the vault in the prison, not the prison, but the court, and they found out that, you know, the cops said we're not going to arrest her because she's a young mom. You know all this stuff. So I mean, it might get to the point where they will arrest her. So it's going to.
Is she like over 100?
No, she's I think like 88 or something.
Yeah,
like that.
I think she's like 80. I was 86, but yeah.
They didn't care about that with the people from Goodfellas when they got locked up. They was 89, 90. About to be dead,
yeah.
Life sentences.
Yeah, Whitey Bulger, like they found him and they arrested him.
That's a fact. They did get Whitey.
We'll see. Maybe we'll see. It's coming out, so we can do
it. We'll see, man. We'll see. But yeah, we're not a fan of that. Just want to put that out there. You got to stab right. We don't got to talk about festivals. Actually, y'all got anything else, man? We can get out of here.
So we doing shout outs.
Oh, yeah. We can do shout-outs. We can do shout-outs.
I'm just asking, man.
I'm
so proud of my people at Beyond Expectations Barber College, man. They opened a humongous new location, man. It's on Glenwood. They got like 19 offices. It got like 150 barber chairs. Nah, it ain't that big. But it's really big, though. They moved into the building next to the funeral home on Glenwood.
Oh.
Jay Washington. Man, it's so big. It gotta be like 40 chairs in there. It's so nice.
I didn't know they did that.
Yeah, me and the crew went up there. I took me and all my kids, of course. We went to the grand opening. It was beautiful.
Oh, that's dope.
That's dope.
Really nice. Really nice in there, man.
That's your shout out. You got one, Shaq?
You can go ahead.
I'm gonna shout out, even though he's not here, I'm gonna shout out DJ Chip Banks and the folks over at Level 8 Studios for what they're doing with the kids and having them. They're actually putting a studio in Chauffin, and they'll be working with the kids on teaching them how to be engineers and not just rappers and stuff like that, but the behind the scenes type of things and learning how to do the boards and all that kind of stuff. So shout out to them for doing that. And they're already started, and it's a good feedback from the kids. They're having fun, so shout out to all of them.
That's sweet. They're going through Chauffin.
Yeah.
So is Beyond Expectations Barber College.
Yeah.
This is
so
great.
It's good because it's giving kids, you know,
different opportunities.
Instead of being a mechanic. You know what I mean? Like, what was the choices we had? Like, mechanic and
a carpenter.
Carpenter.
Masonry.
Everybody don't want to do
nurse.
That.
Right.
And being a nurse or cosmetology. They didn't even have barbering.
So that's shout out to that. Who you got, Shaq?
Shout out to the listeners. I got to pat myself on the back because I've been getting a lot of great feedback from the listeners. So shout out to y'all.
They do. They do like Shaq.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
I don't know if they like you, or like.
Wow. Don't steal my joy.
The name is.
You take my joy.
No, it is good to see in the growth. Like when you first came on to like now, like.
Right,
you're
right,
like super comfortable. Like,
yeah, you got good practice. In yeah, like, I got to get a couple more jumpers.
you up here too.
That'd be cool.
And Shaq also jumped out of airplane with a Can Not The Pod sweatshirt on. So.
Yeah, I did.
Let's get it.
Yeah, I can't wait till I'm the cover of an episode. It's going to be that day. Watch. Just watch.
Ooh, you know what? You know, you're like, you don't really know what to say. Like, yeah, I don't know what to say. Joe, you got a shout out?
Nah.
God damn.
You got a whole bunch of nose.
You said I'll just put you on the spot?
Yeah.
All right, that's cool. This ain't a music podcast. We're going to talk about music. This ain't a movie podcast. Talk about movies, TV. This ain't a sports podcast. Talk about sports. This ain't a porn podcast. Damn sure talked about some porn.
Good lord.
She can't knock though.
Can't Knock The Pod, episode 124. And we out.
That was fun.
Always.